Message from Saint Michael the Archangel. March 10, 2019. Children of God. I am the bearer of the blessing of the Most Holy Trinity, who wish that all men would be saved and come to the full knowledge of the truth. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4. As Prince of the Heavenly Legions, I ask you to fulfill with being missionaries of divine love, and that with that love you attract those brothers and sisters who are living dispersed in vanities, in vices, in criticism, in the quest for everything that is offered to them as modern and as harmful to the soul. Understand that you are called to accept the great divine mercy, Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16, and this is for this instant, prior to the full unfolding of catastrophic trials. For this reason I urge you to accept infinite divine mercy before it becomes dark and you are unable to get up. Dark, yes, when the demons stop merely infecting human creatures and completely possess them through their accepting a life without God. Spiritual decadence has been freely accepted by the majority without encountering opposition in man's reason, in man's interior, in the heart of man. It is rather a terrible acceptance that is heard. Love God and neighbor. Do not continue obscuring the gifts that you would be able to awaken if you stayed in communion with Christ. Do you want answers without making an effort, without leaving behind your everyday routine, despising what reminds you of divine supremacy? You commit sacrilegious acts and great heresies unfolding over the earth at every instant. Ah, but in the midst of wars or catastrophes we hear prayers from human creatures who have not prayed before. Well then? Wake up. Man's folly is endless. You must bow down and proclaim, Our Father, and decide to convert. For this you need enter into and know Christ, willing to love Him and to allow yourselves to be loved by Christ. You cannot love one whom you do not know, you will not respect one you do not know, so you need to know Christ in order to love Him, in spirit and truth. In this way you will be able to discern and will not be deceived, and then you will love God with your soul, powers and senses. Humanity is blind because of the spiritual disorder in which it is living, therefore man is tormented, internally exhausted. These states do not allow man to go to meet Him who is his God and his Lord, but on the contrary lead him to fall into the clutches of the enemy of the soul, the devil and his infernal minions who are on earth. Beloved ones of God, this word that I reveal to you by order of our and your King is not to alarm you, since as humanity you are living in a state of alarm at the aberrant way in which man responds to his Lord and Creator, you live terrified by the heresies that a great majority of human beings are committing, you live in a state of shock at the sacrileges and challenges to the divine will that are continually occurring. Well then, do not be alarmed by what I am announcing to you, but rather by the way that you are living, working and acting, by the sinfulness of human thought, of human feelings, by the lack of sincerity, of love, of forgiveness, by the lack of a heart of flesh so that you may love righteously and so that your intentions may not be folly but truth. How many human beings are facing evil at every instant and do not fear it? How many know that they sin, that with their acts they commit adultery, they commit aberrations, they commit homicides, they break the divine law and are not dismayed about it? How many are not honest in serving the King of Kings? How many know the truth of what is happening and keep a convincing silence, choosing the world and the flesh and scorning what they know to be the truth? How many pray, I believe in Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth, and instantly deny Him in the most terrible way that a human creature can do so? Children of the Most High, the spiritual life of a large part of humanity has deteriorated, so many existing interests want to remove the gospel and leave it without effect so that humanity continues on the path where Satan and his legions are leading you. So many interests exist that want humanity to remain in submission, in controversy, being a mass easy to manipulate. There are so many children of Satan working against the children of Christ and our Queen and Mother in order to hand power over the world to the devil. The devil sets traps for you which, by not having been properly instructed and warned about the purification that humanity is going to experience and the persecutions that the faithful people suffer and will suffer, you do not perceive, you do not accept as indisputable realities. Children of the Most High, many of your brothers and sisters have been persecuted, are being persecuted and will be persecuted, not only by those who are working for evil, but from within the Church itself. I therefore call you to grow so that you keep the faith, and therefore each person must begin a hard work and without losing time, so that you may recognize the divine truth. The divine truth does not change since it is truth and contains the truth for all times. If truth were subject to change, it would cease being divine truth and God would not be God. John chapter 8 verses 31 to 32. Therefore, as the captain of the heavenly host, I call on you to exclaim, "WHO is like God." Revelation chapter 12 verse 7. The Church of Christ is shaking and you, His children, must not deny the faith, but must be aware of that faith, of its foundations, so that it does not falter. Remain in the truth and be aware that the divine truth has been distorted over the generations. Pray for the truth and for the people of our King. Pray for the great nations, they will make serious mistakes. Pray for the children of God that they may resist the coming announcements of the church hierarchy. Pray, the earth shakes, events of nature surprise man. Who is like God? Saint Michael the Archangel. Hail Mary most pure, conceived without sin. Hail Mary most pure, conceived without sin. Hail Mary most pure, conceived without sin. Commentary by Luz de Maria. Brothers and sisters, after these calls, let us not dismiss the words of Saint Michael, who with hammer and chisel wants us to see inside ourselves. The devil is working within humanity, silently spinning his webs, and has he succeeded? The answer is a personal one and each person has it, but as humanity we are being told repeatedly that we have declined in our spiritual relationship with God and therefore in the remaining aspects of life. Saint Michael questions us about man's fear of warnings from heaven and the constant accusations against God himself for causing man to feel fright, fear, and Saint Michael asks, what kind of fear is that of the man who kills, who blasphemes, who is a heretic, who commits sacrileges, who enjoys sin? I am not saying this, it is Saint Michael who is asking, because God is not a thing that is being added to man at this instant, but is what man has that is the most profound and essential, the most holy, and God calls us, he asks us, being so respectful that he allows us to love him freely. We are being called insistently so that we do not live in emptiness and without a spiritual purpose, when we have the great divine mercy from which we can profit if there is repentance of sins committed, and for this we have to know and fulfill God's law. Amen.